Studio, and welcome to Lisa's Stamp Studio. This is a YouTube live streaming event, and today is Monday, May 24th, and the year is 2021. Whether this is your first time visiting my channel or you are returning, I am thrilled that you are here with me. Not only am I going to teach you how to make a spanner card today in really easy steps, that's amazing. We're going to be able to give you a lot more information and tips about paper crafting. So I'm going to walk you through the process to make it easy for you to recreate at home. And I'm going to have lots of tips about the products and how to use them to make paper crafting and stamping much easier for you. I am so glad that you're here with me. I have a couple things I want to go over with you before we get started. The first is I want to introduce you to Gina Hawley. You'll see Gina's name here in blue during the live stream. It's off to the side for the chat. She is here to help interact with you and answer your questions. She's been stamping her whole life, and she is more than qualified to be able to help you with Stampin' Up! Product questions as well as links. So feel free to reach out to her, because quite honestly, it is impossible for me to interact with each of you and be able to answer your questions. So that's what Gina does for you this evening. In addition to that, I want to make sure that you know when tonight's live stream is over, give me just a few minutes. There's going to be a link down in the video description below that will lead over to my website that will give you this, the link to the project sheet. Not only is that going to include the step-by-step cutting dimensions as well as pictures, but all the supplies. And that's not just for the card I'm going to demonstrate for you tonight. It's also for the alternative that I'm going to share with you. Now, I want to give a big shout out to this spanner card to Loanne. Loanne is on my stamping team, and she sent me the spanner card as just a random act of kindness. And I got it and I was like, oh, I have to learn how to make this. So I'm super excited about sharing it with you tonight. And I've got two variations for you as well. And I'm gonna show you Loanne's card as well so you can see another example. All right, the other thing is I wanna make sure that you know that we would love to interact with you. And in order to do so, you're gonna need to log into your YouTube account. That is a YouTube requirement to chat, not one of mine. That would be your Gmail address. So whether you're here for the live or you are here watching the replay, log in and comment, because I come back and read every single comment that you leave. Your feedback is extremely important. I think we're all set. Are you ready? I'm gonna pivot the camera down and we'll get you all zoomed in. Here we go. Don't forget to share tonight's video with your crafting friends. That's one of the highest compliments you can pay me. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button. That is hugely helpful here on YouTube. It helps us to keep content free. What I'm going to do right now is I'm bringing in my paper trimmer here. It's got a clear cutting guide, which I absolutely love, and that's going to play a key factor in tonight's spanner card. So what I've got here is a piece of mint macaron cardstock. We're going to start by scoring this in half. Now, my trimmer has both a scoring and a cutting blade left right here on the trimmer. I love that because they can navigate up and down out of the way, which means I can leave them on the track at the same time. You're going to be able to find the trimmer, as with all the products I'm using tonight, over in my online store at lisastampstudio.com. Just click shop. Let's start by scoring this in half. This is 5.5 by 8.5. Half is at 4.25, and I'm going to use that scoring blade, and we're going to come straight down. That half score line is going to be very, very important before we go too far, because that's actually going to gauge where the extra cut lines are going to go. We are now going to cut next. So I'm going to make sure that my scoring blade is up and out of the way. And then what I'm going to do is make sure that my cutting blade is all ready to go. Now, I'm scoring this beforehand just to make it easier for you to try to see. Now, I know that's kind of difficult in the video, but don't worry, it's super easy. We are going to cut at 1 1/4 inches, but it's very important where you cut from. I'm going to recommend you start at the top here at the seam, which is the crease of your card, and cut towards you. For me, that's easier than trying to go backwards. You're going to find what works best for you. So I'm going to line this here up on my trimmer, and I have a very funny feeling because I'm going to cut towards me. You're not going to be able to see the actual alignment of the score line here at the top. So I just want to show you I'm at 1 1/4 inches here, lining it up across the top. I love that ledge because it keeps things nice and straight for me. I don't do anything straight. Here is that scoring blade. I've got my finger here to keep it up so I can position it. What I'm going to do next is I am going to make sure that I am right on top of that score line. Now, I know you can't see this, and I know you saw my head, and I apologize. There is a score line here, and I can see it through that clear cutting track, and I can kind of feel it. There's a little indication here inside the cutting blade, so I can see where it aligns, and then I'm going to pull. That is going to give us one flap here. Now, we're going to do the other side as well, but here is a great tip for you. Turn it over. Because I'm right-handed, I am looking on the left-hand side, which makes it easier for me, and it's the exact same measurement. So I'm just scooting this down so you can see it's at 1 1/4 inch, and then I'm going to scoot this up so you can see. And again, here comes my cutting blade. I'm trying to get my head a little higher than that camera view so you don't have to see the back of my head again. And then I'm going to score down and cut. And that is going to give us this. Let me push this off to the side. That is all there is to this scanner card as far as scoring and cutting. Now, what's interesting about this is you're going to see all these little flaps and think, well, this is going to be a mess. But boy, do I have a twist on this for you that you are going to love. Let me start by taking my bone folder, and I'm going to come across that crease and just burnish that. I want to make sure that that's going to be nice and flat and easy for me to use. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to work on my focal point for this card, which is going to be a stamped image. So let me push that off to the side, and I'm going to bring in this absolutely beautiful floral image. This is a photopolymer stamp, which means it's completely clear. Love that. And it comes from a stamp set called Hand Penned. Now, this is going to be found in the brand new annual catalog. And if you don't already have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, you can head over to lisasstampstudio.com, click on catalogs, and request or order your copy there. Super fun because, like I said, they're all photopolymer and you're going to be able to use them very, very easily. But here is the best part about the stamp set is it's also offered as a bundle, which means there are coordinating dies. Because I don't know about you, I would never want to fussy cut those, right? When you buy these in a bundle, you're going to save 10%, which is going to give you both because you're going to want one without the other. Let's go ahead and bring in some thick Whisper White, or I keep calling it Whisper White. I keep regressing. We changed the name to Basic White. So this is Basic White cardstock. I'm using the thick because I'm going to be using some Stampin' Blends markers. And alcohol-based markers have a tendency to bleed through the paper. So I find that the thick white cardstock works way better because it spreads better and the colors are more vibrant. Whenever you're using alcohol-based markers, you're going to want to be using a water-based ink pad, and that is what the Memento is. Now, I want to show you something here. You know, the coverage on your ink pad, I don't know why I can't get the lid off. There we go. Probably my arthritic hands tonight. You're going to see that this image is larger than the ink pad. So an important tip for you, turn it face up on your work surface. This is going to ensure if you ink it this way that you're not going to miss a spot. So I'm just going to travel and make sure I get all those lines covered well. And again, because it's photopolymer, whew, that's going to make life easy because you can literally see right through that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stamp that here, and then I'm just going to trace out those lines onto the cardstock. One of the things I hear quite often from stampers is I don't get a crisp, clean image. What am I doing wrong? Well, typically you're going too quickly or you're slamming the cardstock with the stamp. So you want to be sure that you're actually positioning the stamp so that you get a really beautiful, crisp image every single time. Now, I want to bring you in a little closer so I can give you a couple tips about using the Stampin' Blends alcohol-based markers. Now, I, by character, love to color. I find it very, very therapeutic. Is there anybody else with me? But I love these because they provide very flawless professional coverage. Let me show you. They are dual-ended, and you'll see the size of the tip is designated here by that line. They do have snap-on and snap-off lids to keep the alcohol base protected inside the marker. There is a light and a dark shade for every single color that we sell, and you're going to be able to see super easy to use. So I'm just going to stroke on color. Nothing new here, just like you would add a marker to anything. The one thing about this marker, though, that's different than others is if you go over it, as that alcohol evaporates, you're not going to get what I call those streaks, the light and the dark areas. So I'm just going to color in a couple petals because I want to give you some tips about using that darker shade. Now, the other color I decided to use was the mint macaron, which you'll recall matched this, the cardstock that we just cut. That is the beauty of Stampin' Up! Products is that color coordination. This is the light shade, and I'm just going to do the top of the stem and just a little bit down in here. You know, one thing about coloring, especially these whimsical images, don't worry if you go a little bit outside the lines. I often hear people saying, oh, I'm outside the lines a little. It's okay. It's all right. The other thing now is we're going to go back and add some density to this image so we have some what I call graduated tones. I am not an artist by any sense of the mean, although I do love to color. Sometimes your stamps will have little lines in the images. that are cheat marks. They're going to kind of tell you where to place those darker shades. This one doesn't have it. So I just made up my own and I decided that the darker spot was going to be at the bottom because I'm assuming the light is hitting my flower petals from the top. And you're going to see that I'm just brushing on that color. Now, unlike regular magic markers like we just talked about, or even dye-based markers, you're not going to be able to create those two tones very easily. Let's come over and do this area here in the stem, and I'm just going to add a little bit here just for some density. Now, the secret to getting that harsh definition between those two shades to actually blend and look more professional, for me, is coming back to the lightest shade. Now, when the color is a light color like this beautiful pale papaya, you don't have to come all the way down here. You can start here and just drag it up. The magic comes in the few seconds that you need to wait to allow that evaporating of that alcohol to occur so that you'll have that beautiful blended look. And now this is the light of the mint, and we're gonna go back over here. Again, Stampin' Up's color coordination is second to none. Do you see the cheat lines here inside the leaves? I wanna show you something. Use those to your advantage. So you're gonna trace over them with your darker shade and just add a little bit over the top. You will need to allow that alcohol to process because if you lay too much color down too quickly, it'll have a tendency to bleed a little because remember there's some alcohol in there. Now, I'm not gonna color the whole thing because I've got one that's already finished for you. But remember we talked about those dyes and there was a coordinating dye for it. So we're just gonna imagine for a second that it's all ready to go to be die cut. And I've got my clear cutting mat right here. Of course, this will go on my Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine. And then here is my image and here is the die. Now, like all stampers, you know that when you're die cutting, you're gonna have to do a little fuss to find out where it's gonna be positioned. And you wanna take your time to make sure you have it properly aligned where you want it. Here's the next frustration card makers and stampers often have. We get it aligned exactly where we want it. We put that other clear plate over the top and we go to crank it through and you know what happens? This. And then our image does not come out cut straight. So I want to share this with you. This is the Post-it note labeling and cover-up tape. I have fallen in love with this and I want to share this tip with you because if you're like me, this is going to be like your next best friend. I take the tape, it's on a little dispenser, so I just pulled it off. And then what I'm going to do is line up my die exactly where I want it. You're going to anchor this tape across the image, across the die, onto the excess cardstock. That is going to hold it in place while you put the other plate over the top, and then you pass this through your die cutting machine. Then when it comes out looking just like this. Now, I did add a little Winkostella to that, and I'm going to talk to you about that in a second. Now, when it's die cut, I want to share something else with you about this tape. Take your die, and you're going to peel it off, which is going to leave you your die cut image. Take this piece of tape and do not throw it away. I actually tack it right down to my Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine, or you can put it right back here on the dispenser. Now, if you're loving this as much as I am, or you're curious about it, head over to lisastampstudio.com, click on Shop, and then Craft Room Favorites. And you're gonna find this as well as a good slew of products that I absolutely love that aid me in my card making. That's where you're gonna be able to find that if you're curious. So let me move those plates and things off to the side. We've got this beautiful image here. I love shimmer, it's no secret. And if you've ever watched any of the videos on my channel, you know I'm a big lover of bling as well. So the Winkostella pen is actually one of my very favorite things. Because if you like glitter and hate the mess, this is totally for you. Now, when it comes, it has a little spacer in here, so you'll have to unscrew that and take that off. I give it a good shake. You'll want to store it vertically. Do not store it horizontally. You will need to prime the pen the very first time you use it. It says push, and you'll just give it a little squeeze so some of that little wink shimmer comes down through the bristles. And then guess what? You literally just paint it on like a little paintbrush, and itself propels all that shimmer down into those petals, gives you a beautiful, beautiful shimmery look. The other reason I love this is it has an alcohol base and it dries within seconds, so you don't have to worry about manhandling it. Isn't it gorgeous? Absolutely love that. You're going to be able to find the Winkostella in my online store. So I'm going to set that aside for just a moment. And now what we're going to do is we're going to start putting this card together. I just want to move you out just a little bit. And then you'll recall this. And this just screamed it needed decorating to me. So I'm going to open this up flat just to give you a better perspective. And I'm going to bring in my silicone craft sheet. I love this because adhesive, liquid glue, and hot glue will not stick to it, which means it's going to keep my work surface sticky free. Because if you're like me, you've sometimes gotten excited And then you got that sticky spot you're fighting the whole time. So I did some pre-cutting before you joined me, and let me just pull out those pieces here. But you're going to see I put one of them together already. So I've got a beautiful piece of designer series paper. And this comes from the exact same suite of products. And the designer series paper is called Hand Penned. And the papers actually coordinate beautifully with the stamp set. And there's multiple shades of colors. And look at the reverse side. Love it, because then you have something generic you can use all year round. So this, by all means, is not feminine at all. For the front of my card, I'm going to use those stripes. So I'm going to turn this, what will be my wrong side. Let's go ahead and add a little bit of adhesive to that strip. And then I'm going to border this on a piece of basic black cardstock. Now, I get asked this a lot too, is how do you get it so even? Well, number one, I stand. I find it gives me a much better perspective. I hover it and hold it over my paper first to try to get a visual evenness all the way around. So we've got those two panels here. I just saved time and did one of those ahead of time. But here's my secret weapon tonight, and I'm pretty sure you probably can't see this really well because this is a piece of window sheet, better known as acetate. So it's clear. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to lay that here on the silicone craft sheet for just a moment. I'm going to move these off to the side, and I'm going to come over here to my card base. And what I'm going to do is I am actually going to flip this top panel down, look, and we're going to create a bridge right across here for the window sheet. All right, watch me. I'm leaving this on my silicone craft sheet because I realize that this is a very narrow area, and you can lay a strip here if you'd like, or you can go vertically, but you don't want to go too far because this is only about an inch. So I'm going to come all the way to the edge here, and then I'm going to do another one here. I'm going to leave those two angled sides open, and I'll leave it here on the silicone craft sheet so it's a little bit easier for you to see the window sheet. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to line up these edges with the edges of that cardstock, and we're going to tack that in place. I have found, even with the Stampin' Seal Plus, which is what I'm using, that this adhesive, once it's on, is really not as obtrusive as I thought. Plus, it's the inside of the card. But do you see here? We've got a coloredless bridge for this card. Now, wait till you see how these pieces come together. Next, we have those. Let's go ahead and take those side panels. And let's add adhesive here. And one of them is going to go right across here. So again, I'm hovering over the top and I'm looking to try to create an equal margin all the way around the very best that I can. And then we'll tack that in place. And then obviously this one is going to go on the other side. Head over to lisastampstudio.com. You can click on rewards. I offer an incredibly generous ordering rewards program, and I sure would love to be able to have your business and earn your business. All right, there we go. But then I thought, oh, this is way too plain for me. So let's cut another piece of designer series paper, which I did ahead of time, which is here. Same designer series paper package, different pattern. Gotta love that. Lots of choices. So let's go ahead and add these two panels together. I'll add a little adhesive in my four corners, a little down the center. This Stampin' Seal Plus is extremely, extremely strong. So I don't need to use a whole lot. And again, I'm bordering that. And then we're going to flip this over and we're going to add this here, a little bit more adhesive, and that's going to go in that center panel. Now watch. I'm going to make sure that when I open up the card, there's that clear bridge, that this area is flat, and I find turning it horizontally is going to be a lot easier for your hand. I find I have better luck getting things straight this way. And I'm looking to keep it centered only on that center panel of this card, and then we'll press that in place. Okay, so far so good. We're not done because there's more magic to this card. Now let's talk briefly about a greeting because I wanted to be able to use this clear bridge here to my advantage. So I've got a strip piece of Whisper, here we go, Whisper White again, basic white cardstock. It's so hard to teach old dogs new tricks. Anybody else with me? All right, so I've got basic white cardstock here, and I'm going to stamp my greeting here, and I'm going to go back to that Memento black ink pad, and from that exact same stamp set, I've pulled out the words, anything is possible. Great encouraging card. I've got lots of friends right now that are coming out of the pandemic crisis and just trying to get back to normal, and they're all trying to get back on their feet financially and emotionally, and I've got friends I can send that to for some encouragement. I'm sure you've got people you can share with as well. So what I decided to do is I thought, that's a little kind of plain. So I'm going to go ahead and take another die from that die set. and I pulled out myself a piece of scrap basic black cardstock. And I went ahead and I lined this up on here because I know I'm not going to need the whole thing. I used my tape one more time so I don't have to chase that all over the place. And then I die cut a small area, which left me with this. Now, you might hear that little tinging off camera, and I want to show this to you. I get asked about this product an awful lot because people can hear the noise. This is the Titan Magnetic Tray. Game changer. I was forever losing my small dies on my desk. And they were blending in with my cardstock and my background. And I found that this is fantastic. It's also in my craft room favorites under shop over on my website. All right, so let's put these two together. The one reason I absolutely love this scallop die, do you see it? It has a stitched border that goes all the way across here. Really fantastic and really, really trendy. And I purposely cut it longer than I needed because I want to give you another tip. Let's go ahead and let's add adhesive to the back side of the greeting here at the bottom. So we've added some adhesive. I am going to hover this, just over that stitched area. You're going to notice I left it longer on both sides. Again, I did that on purpose. I don't know how many times I tried to purposely measure this piece and I was off by a smidgen. And when you have light paper against dark paper, it is extremely noticeable. So let me tell you what else I do. I come in with what I call my sticky scissors, which I label with some ribbon here in the studio because I hate to gunk up the new ones. I know there's adhesive here. I am going to use that front cardstock as a guide on where to cut the back cardstock. So I'm going to come right along here and I'm going to snip this off and then I can come back in and just kind of shimmy that a little bit and it's going to be perfect every single time. And look at, I don't have to worry about cutting that the right length, especially for those borders. That's such a hassle, isn't it? All right, so now that is all set. We are going to add some adhesive to the back side of this as well. So I'm going to add a little here and a little down here at the bottom. And this now is going to go underneath that clear bridge. Remember I talked about this? But I want to give you an important tip. You want to make sure that this area is not wider than this area for the bridge. So what I like to do is very gently just place that here on my cardstock. I am not pressing it down in case I have to move it. And you see, I do. So I'm going to take those words and I'm going to shimmy them down near the very bottom. And I want to make sure that it falls within that bridge. Yep, and that looks really good. Let's go ahead and press that down. Ooh, that's pretty, but we're not done yet. Remember, we have a flower, but guess what? Not only do we have layer one, we have layer two. We've got to do something here and wait till you see how this comes together. This is fantastic. Now, I did this ahead of time. I stamped a greeting here for the inside of my card to correspond with my outside sentiment. And I took that from the stamp set called Elegantly Said. Not only are these really amazing, they stamp just like this, by the way, beautiful for heat embossing, but I absolutely fell in love with the mixed font greetings. Super classy, very, very pretty. So I stamped that here. I also took two more pieces of designer series paper. Remember, those were the backside of one of those patterns. I added black panels for them. Now, if you're thinking, oh my gosh, this is a lot of cutting dimensions, don't you worry. I got you covered in that free project sheet that you're going to be able to download when the live stream is over. Now, where you put these is very important because the perimeter on the front of the card and on the inside of the card have to be the same. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this white piece and I'm turning it horizontally again to make it easy for my hand. I'm lining up the outside edge of this black layer to the outside edge of the inside of the white cardstock. And I'm looking just to align that. And we'll tack that in place. This is going to make more sense on why the alignment is so important in just a moment. Let's go ahead and add this one now to this side. Let's go ahead and turn that so it's more in your view and not mine. And then we're going to align that outside edge as well. You want to make sure that your layers are coming all the way to the edge. And if you don't like to layer this much, that's fine. You can just adjust these sizes. This now is going to get flipped over. Let's add our adhesive to the back side. And now what we're going to do is we are going to add this to the inside of the card. So let me just go over this again. This is the bridge. This is the center. And then this is the inside. You want to make sure that you're looking the very best that you can to have this centered. So you're looking at the top and the sides and the bottom, so that there's about equal space. And then once you think you're happy with it, go ahead and tack that down. Because this is where that beautiful spanner card comes in. This is going to come down to here. This is going to come down to here. Let's go ahead and add that flower, and we're going to add some embellishments. Wait till you see this come to life. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to close this because this positioning of the clear acetate here is going to be very important on where we place this. You want to make sure that when you adhere this, you don't put any adhesive here that's going to stick in the center panel. Otherwise, you won't have that trifold opening. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip this over and I'm going to grab some dimensionals. Now, I know I'm going to gravitate on this side because remember, this side is going to fall here. So I'm going to take a couple dimensionals. And I'm going to go here and here, and that's kind of small. So we're going to come in with my mini dimensionals. This is my take your pick tool. I can't live without this thing. I love it because there's a putty tip to pick up your cardstock and sequence. Love the interchangeable tips. This is the paper piercing tool attachment because that helps me take off those paper backings with ease. Now I know the dimensionals or the sticky is on this one side. So I'm going to gravitate this to here and I'm very cognizant of where those are. You want to make sure that they're going to fall properly. You don't want them to fall on the inside of your card. All right, so I'm going to just lightly tack that down. I'm going to open. Yep, that looks really good. There's nothing sticky than holding this closed. All right, let's come into these genial gems because I can't help myself. We got to add some bling. So here in the flower center was really intuitive to me. And these have glue dots already on the back. So let's go ahead and put one of those here. This really plays up that wink of Stella. Oh, so, so pretty. Here's another one. And I'm going to place that here. And I'm going to use several more. And I'm going to tell you why. I find that odd numbers are very appealing to the eye. Work in a triangle because it's going to gravitate your eye in that direction. But that wasn't enough for me because I thought this side kind of looked plain. So I'm going to take another larger one. We're going to place that one here. And then I've got another smaller one that I'm going to place here. Now, don't go away. I've got another variation of the spanner card that I'm looking forward to sharing with you. So let's go through this one more time. Isn't this pretty? So it opens up with the bridge, and then it opens up in the center, and then you have this. So the alignment of that center is really, really, really important. Isn't that pretty? It looks difficult, but it's super, super easy. Now, let me show you a couple other samples. This one I made where the bridge was solid. This is using the stamp set called Sailing Home, and I use the coordinating dies called Smooth Sailing. Now, this is no longer offered as a bundle with the dies because it was carried over from a previous year, but you're going to want one without the other because wait till you see the inside. Very simple, masculine, monochromatic pattern. There is nothing fancy about this, but I use the dies on the designer series paper. So if you have designer paper that is really kind of plain and simple, but it has some ombre look, don't overlook stamping on it. So watch what happens. We're going to have a big pop of color here. And there's our ground kind of in our C there. And then on the inside, that's where we went ahead and I used one of those dies just to keep this very simple color palette. Plenty of room to stamp or write a message here. Makes a fantastic card for any occasion. And of course, you can change up the sentiment. This label die actually comes as part of the die set here. Now, the last card I want to share with you is the one that Loanne made and sent me, who is on my stamping team. And that's where I got the inspiration for this card. I had never seen a spanner card before. She used the medium daisy punch with some retired, really beautiful gems here. Underneath her window, she actually stamped her greeting. Very similar border. And then she did a little bit more here in the center. Instead of designer paper, she used an embossing folder for texture. You'll see that her window doesn't go all the way across. I found it easier for me if I went all the way across because then I could get it really nice and aligned. And then, of course, here in the center. So a really, really fun card and a great way for you to use up those designer series paper scraps. So here are the cards that are going to be in your project sheet. Again, that link is down below the video title. Can't wait to share that with you. Now, while you're here, I want to talk to you very quickly about this. Those of you that follow me on Facebook probably have not seen this because numerous times I've tried to share it and numerous times Facebook has said it's against their Facebook policy. This is free, my friends. This is a free digital download. It's called United Through Creativity. Stampin' Up! Is offering this absolutely free, and I want to show you some of the images in here. Love, love, love those, and you're going to get fonts, and there's all kinds of things for people all over the world. So if you live in another country, we've got other languages covered. Look at this. Isn't this fun? completely free. You're going to head over to my website, click on shop, and then you're going to click over on specials, and you're going to find the digital download there. Look at some of these images. Aren't these adorable? I don't know about you, but if it's free, it's always for me. And that's called United Through Creativity Digital Download. Completely free. Go grab yours right away. You'll absolutely love that. And of course, the Spanner card. Now, let me talk to you about a couple of things that are coming up. And of course, the next live so you can mark your calendar. I'm so glad that you've enjoyed the card. I love reading your comments. Something really big is going on right now, and it's giving you extra rewards for shopping. And it's something that Stampin' Up! Is offering. Right now, if you have a large order of $250 in product or more, I know some of you are thinking, no way, it's not hard to get there, believe me. They're giving you an extra $25 in Stampin' Rewards. That means the free product they would normally give you of $25 at $250 is actually doubled. They're adding $25 more. If your wish list is even bigger than that, the extra $25 is even added to that. Now, while I talked about that project sheet with you just a few minutes ago, if you love PDF tutorials with step-by-step written instructions, cutting dimensions, and a list of supplies and multiple photos, you are not going to want to miss my PDF library over at lisastampstudio.com. You'll find it underneath classes. It is vast. You can page through there and find all kinds of samples. They are available for immediate download. I charge $1 per page for all of that work and all those beautiful samples for you to be able to recreate at home. The last thing is I want to make sure that you mark your calendar because I'm coming back live with you next Monday. That is May 31st at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Some of you have asked, geez, it's Memorial Day. Yeah, I know. It's a great day to stamp at 8 p.m. So I hope that you'll join me at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Head over to Lisa Stamp Studio, sign up for our newsletter, like, share, and comment tonight. And I look forward to having you join me next Monday. Gina, thanks for all your hard work and interaction tonight. I look forward to seeing you all then. Have a great evening.